Hi, AT from CNC at home. I wanted to put together a quick card for Mother's Day, and I'm going to do that by cutting some 110-pound cardstock. It's white, and I'm going to paint it as well, so I'll get some color into it. The issue with cutting letters, is which I'm basically going to do, is that parts of the letters will fall out that you want to stay in there. So, for instance, an O. If you have an O on there, and let's just put one on here real quick. If we did that, let's zoom in on it, this center part will just fall out, and this will just be a big blank hole. So what we need to do is attach the center piece to the outer edge. One way to do that would be to switch the font to Stencil, which I've typically used. And see how it makes these little connections? That way these inner pieces will always stay put. But I don't want to use Stencil. I want to use another font that doesn't do that on its own. How do we do that? That's what this video is going to be about. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's get into how we actually are going to do this. Let's change this font once again. I'm going to use a font called Elephant, of all things. Where is it? Up here in the E's. There it is. Now this O is going to fall apart. The first thing we really want to do is type out our message. It's going to be simple. I'm just going to do something simple like that. Happy Mother's Day. And I need to change our settings to line. I'm also going to go down into my library and see if I can pull this up. This should be the 110. We'll assign that to the layer so we know that the burn parameters are good. So that's basically what we're going to cut. The problem is this little piece of the A, the inside of these P's, the O, this part of the E, even this part of the H, even though it's attached down here, it's not on the top. It'll get kind of floppy, so we'll want to attach it here. The inside of the D and another A, we want to get those secured so they don't fall out. And here's the easy way to do that. I'm going to create a rectangle. Just some random size rectangle. Doesn't matter how long it is. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to unlock our aspect ratio so I can change one size but not the other. Well, I got really close here. I want to do this at 0.6. I found that for this particular font size, a 0.6 wide tab works really well. So this is basically the tab that we have. What I want to do with our little rectangle is place it where I need those tabs to be. And because I haven't locked my aspect ratio, I can stretch this down and the width doesn't change. Before I do anything with this, I'm going to copy it. I can say right-click copy. I can also do Control-C on a Windows machine. Now I have one of those stored in my copy buffer and we can use it later. That's basically where I want my tabs to be, so I'm going to select both of those items. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to select my subtract. By subtracting it, now you can see it's left these nice little tabs. It's going to hold this piece in place. So that's pretty slick that I can do that. I need to do that on both of these P's. So I'm just going to paste in my rectangle. Come up here, position it where I want that to be. Stretch it down. And do the same thing. I'm going to subtract it. Put another one in place. Do the exact same process over here. Select both pieces. Subtract it. So you can see that works pretty easily. These little pieces are going to stay put when I do the cutting. I'm going to go ahead and do that for the rest of these areas that need that, and I'll just do a little fast forward. On this last one, I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut. I'm going to do an Alt minus. And if you're doing a bunch of these, using keyboard shortcuts can help speed things up. Now, if we take a look at this, everything should be held in place. this part of the A, this part of the D, or E. We've added this on our H to help secure this so it doesn't flop around. O, A, and our P's. Looks good. If we go into preview, go full screen on that. You can see how it's going to add these tabs to hold our pieces on. We can do a quick play. See how that's going to burn. This is relatively quick. It's going to take less than 2 minutes to do. The other thing I do want to do on this is basically cut this out. I want to put a rectangle or a square around it. So we'll just do an approximation here. We'll do about like that. And that looks pretty good. What I do want to do is I want to fold this extra piece in half so I can have some color behind this, either insert something or paint the backside of this flap. So to do that, I'm going to extend this a specific amount. I'm going to anchor it in the lower left-hand corner, and I'm going to make it grow in the width by 200%. So it's exactly twice what I need. Then I can just fold it in half, and that'll work pretty well. I'll just put this whole mess, select all, put that in my lower left-hand corner of my working area. I also want to ensure that this last rectangle is cut out after all of the internal stuff. It likely would. I believe there's a setting where I have all the internal stuff cut first. Yeah. So under Optimize, I do say cut inner shapes first. And that should work. We do a quick preview. And if we look at this, yeah, the last thing it did was it cut that external piece out. To ensure that it does that, I'm going to take this and set it on its own layer. By putting it on its own layer, then I can control that to assure or ensure that it cuts last. I also have it set up that the cutting will happen in my layer order. So I have my black layer and then I have my blue layer. If for some weird reason I wanted to cut the exterior out first, I can swap these around. If we look at our preview, we do a play, you'll see that it cuts the outside first. So that particular setting does override some of the optimization. So be careful with that if you're doing this. Make sure that you put your cut last. Just take a quick look at that again. Do play, does our letters first, and then it does our border. That's all set to go. Let's take this over to the laser and get it cut. That looks pretty nice. It's a keeper. We'll use it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. It really helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.